Hello, my name is Sascha Tatil, and today I'm talking about the how to write professional business emails. This is also a tutorial where I will show how to write an email, so we go through it step by step. First thing I will do is I will start a new mail. I will just start an email. This is Outlook. Usually Microsoft Outlook is used for writing emails. Of course, nowadays many use Gmail as well, but the process would be the same. This is just for an example purpose, and of course this is for business purposes, and for business purposes even today people are using Microsoft Outlook. So what is important when writing business emails? It is different from writing to a friend, because if you write to a friend, you can write whatever you want. There's no need for any cultural things. You can just use some smileys or whatever, or you don't even need to use the name. But when you write professional emails, you need to be careful and also write it in a very professional manner. So we will start here with the first introduction. Hello, Mr. Smith. So there are a few things important when writing even this first thing. First of all, you should write it correctly, the name, because the name, according to many experts, is the, or to many people, it's the most important thing to a person. So if you write the name wrong, it's a big insult. So avoid writing the name wrong. Double check the name, even if in the matter you are writing there are some mistakes. That is not a big issue. But if you write the name incorrectly, then definitely the person will not be happy. After that, you go to the introduction and say, "Yeah, you say something pleasant." The best thing always is to start with something pleasant and say, for example, "Thank you for the information. In our call today." And after the introduction, you go to, I mean, in the first introduction, you just also say something pleasant, and also you connect to some discussions maybe which happened previously, and then you say, okay, and then you can go to the matter, what you actually want from that person. For example, "Kindly send me the login details for the project." So if you ask someone for something, it is always good to explain why you need this, because the last thing you want is that someone thinks you are ordering them around. But you can tell, okay, the reason, for example, "So that way I can have a first look at the project." And then you can already end this by saying, "Looking forward to hearing from you." And this is called a call to action, this end part. It could be something you are doing. For example, it could be, the last sentence could also be like, "I will be calling you on, let's say, Friday at this and this time." Or you could write, "I will finish this task till Thursday," or something like that. So either it could be something you are doing till a specific time, or you could ask them to do something. For example, in this case, you're asking for the login details. And in the end, you add the signature. Usually it's possible to add a signature automatically in Outlook, but it should always look like as if you have written at least the "kind regards" and your name by yourself, and it was not automatically generated. So in my emails, usually it always looks like that, And usually I also write, usually also by hand, this kind regard, Sascha Tatil. So by doing that, you're giving a little bit more respect and also more that you're caring for the other person and not just sending in a mail. In the subject, you can write something regarding our call today. So if it's something like that, then also the chances that they open this mail is also much higher. Of course, they will open it when they see you had a discussion today. But usually these kind of work-related emails are always opened. So, and another thing here to see is if you have longer matters to discuss, I think it is not a good idea to write long emails, because long emails will always lead to confusions, maybe misunderstandings most often, and maybe people get insulted by that. So it's always better to ask in those mails, to keep those mails short, and then ask the person to meet, for example, on Skype, or have a voice conversation or a phone call, or even meet in person to person. But don't write long mails. Also always keep it short, only if you know that you have to give some kind of a report or an offer. Then, for example, you can use an attachment to the mail, or even you can write the offer inside the mail. But as I said, writing something long is always not a good idea. It's always better if it's a longer matter, then always have also a call to explain what is actually meant by these things. And then another thing which you might always want to check is like the spacing. I mean, for example, you could give two spaces here, two lines after "Hello, Mr. Smith," and then also at the end you can give two lines so that it's easier to see, and also between the introduction, the subject matter, and also the ending, you can keep one line or one space free, so it becomes much more easy to read. For example, if you write it like this, it will be much more difficult to read, and it might not be also clear exactly what you want. But if you write it in this manner, it becomes very clear that this is what you want. You want login details. Of course, maybe if you clog it all together in one block, then maybe that's also possible. But for the readability purposes, it's always better to give some proper spacings, and then it is easier and for them to read, and it so also looks more professional. And if you always keep this kind of method to whomever you write to, then your standing will also become better, because they will see you as a professional. And regarding that name, in some countries, for example in Germany, you are not supposed to immediately use the first name. So if the name is Michael Smith, then in the first mails you use "Hello, Mr. Smith." And if you want to use the first name, then, for example, in your call, you can ask, okay, is it fine for you to use the first name? Or maybe they start using the first name, then you could also use the first name. Then it could be "Hello, Michael," right? So, but in some countries, you cannot go, I mean, you can do it, but it will look a little bit rude, as if you're taking something which you're not supposed to do. So always start with the second name, and after that you get more familiar, and they are also allowing the first name, you can go to the first name. That is it about this whole professional business email writing. I think there's not much more to it. Only thing is like the starting, give a nice pleasant introduction, write the subject matter you want the other person to do, or and in the end, give also something pleasant and maybe a call to action, what happens next. I mean, for example, looking to hear from you, or I will be sending you the documents by Thursday. So a call to action at the end, and then the signature. And as I said, when it comes to signature, try to make it personal, write as if it is a new written signature, not the whole signature, but at least this kind regards or best regards, so that they know that you care about them. That's it about writing professional business emails. If you have more questions, you can write in the comment section. You can subscribe to this channel. There will be more tutorials and information, and also you can like this this video. Thank you, and I'm hoping to hear from you soon.